Up to now, we've established vanishing points and we've used those to create objects like our box that we've been producing onto here. But I want to do something which is quicker than that now. I don't necessarily need to draw vanishing points every time. So let me look at a technique which is about creating quick perspective cubes. It starts off with a rather simple Y shape. If we take this arm, we know that it goes to a vanishing point, and so we know that the arms this side will come in to that vanishing point and the arm this side will come in to a vanishing point. So I can sketch them in just quite crudely like that, knowing that they conform to that slight perspective. And the same with this side. I can sketch in lines like that, knowing that I use that one as a guideline going toward this imaginary vanishing point. I can then construct verticals to produce that. So that Y technique can give me very quick perspective cubes. There's the Y. I draw those lines in. I use that arm to judge that line and that line. I drop down those verticals and I'm producing rather quick shapes. Now, I know these are only cubes, but they could be a whole number of different forms. They could be the starting point for quite complex perspective drawings. So our Y technique is enabling me to produce some very quick sketch forms that I can then use for more complicated drawings. We can develop that further by changing the angle of that Y shape. You can see now that this arm is much flatter, that one is much steeper. But again, the principle holds true that I'm drawing it to the vanishing points here and here and using that arm to judge that and that. And you can see how you can begin to create a whole range of different views on that cube simply by following those. I can see mostly this face, or if I change the Y to look like that, I can drop that down, produce that face, produce those lines, and I'm seeing now mostly that face. I can make the Y look very flat indeed, so I'm seeing mostly the tops, mostly the sides and not the top, or I can change that to look very dramatic like that, where I can see mostly the top surface of that cube. So I've got a page of cubes there where I'm deciding what I see as important. I can see the front face and not the top, or I can see the top and not the sides. The decision is up to you as the graphic artist, how you get people to see that cube.